As AI tools like ChatGPT change how people find information, getting your site visible in ChatGPT search is becoming just as important as ranking on Google. While ChatGPT doesn't index sites traditionally, it pulls data from sources like Bing. So in this video, you'll learn how to optimize your content so it appears in ChatGPT-powered responses and stay ahead in the AI-driven search era. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users, and this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if this is your first time on our channel, subscribe. Now, OpenAI has published this document where it says, OpenAI uses web crawlers and user agents to perform actions for its products, either automatically or triggered by user requests. And these are the three user agents or robots that will visit your website for information. The OAI search bot is the main crawler used specifically for indexing websites for ChatGPT search. The ChatGPT user bot handles real-time user queries by fetching live data to improve accuracy, and the GPT bot is used to gather data for AI training purposes. Now here's the key. For your website to show up in ChatGPT responses, two things must happen. Firstly, your website must be indexed by Bing, and secondly, your content must be accessible to the OAI search bot. If either of these isn't in place, your content may not appear in ChatGPT responses. So let me walk you through the steps to get your site indexed in ChatGPT. You know, when you go to a private club, there are always bouncers who prevent uninvited guests from entering, right? Robots.txt is just like the bouncer for your website. It tells all the robots on the web who is allowed and who is not allowed to enter and crawl the website. And the thing you need to know is that by default, if the robots.txt document is completely blank, all robots are allowed to enter and crawl the site. If you are a RankMath user, you can edit the robots.txt file directly on your site. Hover over RankMath SEO and go to its general settings. Then you will see the edit robots.txt option here. If you have never amended your robots.txt, this is the default generated by RankMath. Now, as you can see, this is calling all robots. Whether it is robots from Bing, Google, Amazon, or whatever, this line calls for all of them. And we are only preventing all robots from indexing backend admin pages. But we still allow all robots to access front-end functionalities like lazy loading, forms, filters, etc. So by default, all robots including BingBot, OAI SearchBot, GPTBot, etc. can access your site. You don't have to specifically call on a particular agent and allow them to visit your site. Every bot is allowed to visit your site by default. And in case you want to prevent OpenAI from using your content for AI training, you can block the GPT bot from accessing your site by adding this line of instruction in the robots.txt file. Using this, it doesn't affect your site's visibility in ChatGPT search unless you add this to the robots.txt. And it doesn't make sense for you to change this disallow to allow because by default, robots are allowed to access your site. So if you want to allow this robot to access the site, simply remove the directive. Now let's save this. Now the next thing you want to do is to verify if the OAI search bot is able to access your site through the robots.txt. So you can visit this robots.txt tester and validation too. This is the link. Simply enter your site's URL, search for the user agent, but if it is not on this list, you can type it out and test it. And now right here, you want to test it again. And it shows that the OAI search bot is allowed to visit your site. But if we change this to GPT bot, which is right here, and we test it, we will see that it is not allowed to visit our site. So amending your robots.txt directly from RankMath is very simple. So if you do not see the names of the three OpenAI robots in the document, most likely you do not need to do anything. But the next thing you need to do is this. Since ChatGPT search depends heavily on Bing's index, getting your website properly indexed by Bing is essential. To do that, you want to first go to Bing Webmaster Tools site. This is the link. And then you want to click on Get Started. If you already have a Google account where you have verified your site with, I recommend that you log in with the same account. From here, I recommend that you import your sites from Google Search Console if you have already done so to Bing. The process is rather straightforward if you do this. However, if you have not connected your site with Google Search Console, you can use this other method to connect your site manually. Simply add your site's URL and click Add. Then, Bing will provide you with different methods to verify your site. This is to ensure that you are the owner of the site and not somebody else. So for us, we'll use the HTML meta tag option, as we can directly add the authorization code in RankMath. We will click on this to copy the authorization code, then go back to our site. We want to hover over RankMath SEO and select its general settings. Following that, the webmaster tools. From here, you want to paste the copied codes here. You don't have to amend anything and hit save changes. And as you can see, only the codes will be added. Then you want to go back to Bing webmaster tools and click verify. Give it a while and the site is verified. Just click done. And now you will have access to your site's Bing webmaster tools. From here, you can go to the sitemaps option and submit your sitemap. Sitemap is like the Rolodex of your site. It lists every single indexable URLs on your site, all in one place. And as a RankMath user, to get your sitemap's index, you can go to the sitemap settings, and the sitemap link is right here. As you can see, these are all the different sitemaps, and in each individual sitemap, there are all the URLs in it. This is a good SEO practice, to have all your individual sitemaps into a sitemap index. So you want to copy this link, go back to your Bing Webmaster Tools and paste your sitemap link here and hit submit. And here you go. And now Bing will send its robots to our site to crawl all our indexable pages. So these are the two major things you need to get your site on ChatGPT search, but there are other things you probably heard of that can improve the chance of your site getting mentioned. Now, the LLMS.txt file is a text file for you to include your most important pages so that large language models immediately know what your site is about instead of wasting resources crawling your entire site. It is a proposed standard that allows you to communicate directly with large language models like ChatGPT. More and more businesses, products, services, and AI models are adopting this standard, and it looks something like this. Seems complicated, but it's actually easy to understand and implement. So if you are implementing this standard right now, you are planning for the future. All you need to do is to log into your web hosting account and include the LLMS.txt file directly on your website's root folder. But if you are a RankMath user, even the free version, you can easily create the file without logging into your web hosting account. Simply visit RankMath's dashboard, scroll down and you will see the module called LLMS Text. As you turn the module on, the file will automatically be created for your site. To view it, you can either click on the settings button here or visit the general settings and click on the edit LLMS.txt file. From here, you will see that the file is located through this link. Currently, the file only includes your XML sitemap, but you can easily add links here. Go back to the settings and let's say that most of your content is in a post type. Let's select that and save the settings. Now, as you visit the file again, you will see that your content has been added in the way that ChatGPT and other large language models understand. Now, this file is supposed to include only the most important links. And if you wish to customize it, you can add your links through this additional content area. As for this setting, it will limit the number of links to be included for each selected post type. If you want to learn more about the LLMS text file, including the best practices and its syntax so that you can customize the file, believe me, it's actually very simple. You can check out this video right here. It covers everything you need to know, including how to create the file on your web host. As you know, ChatGPT search often gets information from Bing, and as a result, most of the traditional SEO optimization still works, and having a good site structure is one of them. For example, if you run a cooking recipe site, a good site structure would start with clear main categories like recipes, cooking tips, and meal plans. Under recipes, you could have subcategories such as chicken, duck, fish, etc. For meal plans, you can have subcategories such as breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And the relevant content will be sorted according to the categories. This hierarchy is called the silo structure. It helps both users and search engines understand the relationship between pages and allows internal links to flow naturally. And if you are new to site building, I highly recommend that you watch this video right here as we go in depth into everything you need to know about silo structure. And as your site grows, watch these two other videos to expand your site structure. The links to the videos are in the description. Creating relevant content comes with knowing what your target audiences are searching for. You may say people don't actually search for exact keywords in ChatGPT, and I agree with you. Most users phrase their questions conversationally. But remember, when ChatGPT has access to the web via Bing, it retrieves information from top-ranking search results. That means it still analyzes and summarizes content that is optimized for traditional SEO keywords. So while the input may be more natural, the output still depends heavily on keyword reach, well-structured content that ranks well on search engines. That said, you should use tools like Google Keyword Planner to find keywords that your audiences are searching for by clicking on Discover New Keywords. Assuming you run a personal finance blog focusing on budgeting, you can start with a seed keyword such as budgeting. Currently, we are only searching for keywords in Singapore, but if your target audience is worldwide, you want to click on the country, remove any selected countries, and click Save. And you will see all locations selected. And then if you already have an established website, you can place your URL here to filter unrelated keywords. If not, you can click Get Started. And in just a few seconds, you will have a list of keywords that your target audiences are searching for. There is a lot more to doing keyword research, and I can't cover everything in this video. So if you want an in-depth guide on that, you can check out this video right here. And once you have done your keyword research, I highly recommend that you have an AI to write the first draft for you. On your WordPress dashboard, hover over RankMath SEO and visit the Content AI module. If you haven't tried the Blog Post Wizard 2 yet, we highly recommend that you do so because it writes high-quality long-form content on just about any topic. This tool comes with a three-step process. If you have done your keyword research, you wouldn't need to follow through with the first step that generates a blog post idea, so I would skip it. Now, the next step is to create an outline, which is important. So assuming the keyword we are targeting is money management tips for beginners, we will add that in the topic field. And then for the main points and ideas, typically I would leave it empty so that the AI will generate its own ideas. But feel free to add your input, or you can click on this to generate some ideas. But for me, I will keep this empty. And for the audience, you would choose appropriately, such as students and professionals. And if you don't see your target audience in this list, feel free to customize it. Next, the focus keyword in this case is the same as the topic. So I will copy the topic and paste it in this field. For the tone, since we want to make our article conversational, we will select conversational, then friendly and casual. Similarly, you can customize the tone such as witty and hit comma or tab, and the tag will be created for it. As for the style, you see there are many different types of content style, but I think this calls for a listicle because we are listing down all the money management tips. Then you can choose the language. There are 28 languages to choose from and counting. And when we are done, we will click on Generate. And in just a while, we will have an outline. It is important to agree with the generator outline because the content will be based on it. So if you are not happy with this outline, you can click Regenerate. But if you are happy with it, you can click Write Post, and it will start analyzing the topic and write the content. Give it a while for it to complete the content. And here we go. It has generated over 1,000 words. Next, click on Create New Post. And the content will be added to a new blog post, and they will be properly formatted. Remember, this should always be the first draft and not the final content. You should always check for content accuracy, factual claims with sources, clarity and readability, etc. And this leads us to the next tip. ChatGPT is designed to understand and respond to human-like everyday language, and when your content mirrors the way people naturally ask questions, it becomes more relevant to AI systems trained on large volumes of conversational data. For example, instead of writing optimal methods for household energy conservation, a more conversational approach will be, what are the best ways to save energy at home? This mirrors how users actually phrase their questions when interacting with ChatGPT. You should also anticipate common questions and answer them in natural ways, such as instead of titling a section, hydration and electrolyte balance, write something like, why is drinking water so important when you are sick? You should make your content sound more natural and conversational, especially in the heading and the first paragraph after each heading. Even though ChatGPT itself does not rely on structured data to understand content, it is still important because, as we said, ChatGPT uses Bing to find information. Whether it is Bing, Google, or any traditional search engine, they use structured data to better understand and rank pages. And it also qualifies content for rich results like feature snippets, reviews, knowledge graphs, etc. As a result, contents that acquire rich results are more likely to be cited or shown in AI-generated responses. As a RankMath user, you can easily implement the right structured data for your content. On the site level to gain knowledge graph, such as when you search for WordPress on the search engines, there is this section that gives you more information about the company or the thing you are searching for. To do that, you can go to RankMath's titles and meta, and in the local SEO module, you can complete all the information such as your website name, your site logo, your email address, and the exact schema type that clearly describes your business. Then the opening hours and all the nitty-gritty details, so that it gives your site a higher chance of getting the knowledge graph. There is a lot more to acquiring the knowledge graph, and we have talked about this in this video right here. Feel free to check it out, the link is in the description. Anyway, other than the site-wide structured data, you can apply relevant schema types to each page of your site. When you create a new post page or custom post type, click on the RankMaths tab, and on the third icon, you will see the schema options. When you click on the schema generator, you can apply the appropriate schema type for your page. Assuming you are writing a long-form review on WP Rocket, which is a WordPress plugin, on top of the article schema that is applied by default, if you have RankMath Pro, you can add another schema type, such as the software schema. Include everything you know about WP Rocket, together with your personal rating and pros and cons, and your page stands a chance of getting a star rating rich snippet on the search engines. It is known that the more quality backlinks your site has, the higher the chance your content will rank at the top, because backlinks are like vote of confidence from other sites, giving a signal to search engines that your site is trustworthy. The strategy to earn backlinks when your site is new is totally different from the strategy for established site, because if you use the same strategy for a new site, your site will only attract low-quality backlinks. Hence, we have talked about the different stages and strategies to use to acquire backlinks in this video right here. I'm pretty sure you'll gain a lot of knowledge from there. Alright, with all that, we need to know if ChatGPT is actually crawling your site, and most importantly, if it is sending traffic to your site. Most hosting dashboard includes access to raw logs. So for example, if your hosting provider uses DirectAdmin, you will look for a section like Site Summary, Statistics, and Logs. And then you want to select the usage log for a particular site, and in that log, you want to search for bot. And if you see Bing bot, it means Bing bot has visited your site and crawled your pages. Or if you see OAI search bot, it means ChatGPT has visited your site. Now, unfortunately, my hosting provider do not provide such access, hence I'm only able to show you screenshots from my colleagues. But a better way to know if ChatGPT visited my site is if it is sending traffic to my site. For example, if we visit Google Analytics, under the traffic acquisition report, you will see all the traffic that are coming to your site. But this is in general. There could be many different types of referrals, not just one. What you want to do to segregate the traffic is to filter out the session source or medium. And from here, you will see that ChatGPT has actually sent traffic to my site. The same goes for other AI search platforms like Perplexity. So after implementing all this, I'm pretty sure that your site will be mentioned as a source, not only on ChatGPT, but also on other AI search platforms. If you have any questions or you know any strategies that I have not mentioned, or you have experience with this topic, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And if this video helped, do help us out by smashing that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.